On this episode of the Hockey Card Show, we talk the Mad Swinger, the Bitch Slapper, and the Lord.
This episode of the Hockey Card Show is brought to you by Ice Hot Hockey. Ice Hot Hockey is 100% hockey cards for the hardcore NHL fan. You can check out all their auctions over on their eBay homepage. Just search for Ice Hot Hockey.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to the Hockey Card Show. I'm Justin Kendrick. You know Darren Reynolds.
Yes.
We call him Dink here on the show. Actually, everyone calls him Dink. And we've just kind of gone along with it.
Yeah, why not?
So that's fun. We are going to sit back.
You sported the toque again.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Well,
I'm a little under the weather, so I'm trying to stay warm. And hopefully I don't get all disgusting while we shoot. Because I'm a little stuffed up. But
stuffed up? You got the runny nose, I got the red lips.
Nice. Like Daniel Alfredson and the Titian.
Darren Titian.
Yeah. So we're going to sit back and crack some packs of hockey cards, like we like to do. Talk about some hockey. All-Star game just passed.
Yes, it did.
Thoughts, quickly?
Truth be told, I only saw the draft and the skills. The draft was somewhat entertaining. The skills were kind of what they always are. And I saw about 5 minutes of the game, which is more than I actually planned on. So overall, I think it was okay. And that's saying something for me because I thought it was a bit of a joke going in because they always are.
Yeah. I expected to see a bit of everything, and I actually saw all of everything.
You saw the whole game,
I recorded the skills competition and watched it Sunday morning. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed everything more than I thought I was going to.
That's good.
The game certainly was a little bit boring, other than last week, 5 minutes when... You know, people are actually putting like some stick checks on there and getting the active
sticks. That's what
sticks.
I heard. It was actually getting close.
I was
close,
like, huh, right? Okay. But I really liked it. I, the draft was fine, and the skills competition. I like the big thing that I like about these type of events is that you get to see a little bit personality and actual the players and how they, you know, talk and interact and joke around with each other. I like that. That's
the,
my big
the candor, if you will.
There you go.
Yeah, yeah, I like that too. Where you see guys that you wouldn't expect talking, Ovi and Fleury.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. That's kind of cool.
Or like, yeah, like Ovechkin.
Meanwhile, they probably don't like each other because Letang went over to Fleury after. Did you see that in the skills? After Ovi came in on Fleury for his creative shooting or whatever the hell it was.
Creative assignment.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's creative writing. Then Letang came over and said something to Fleury. I wonder if he's still a douchebag.
Well, and then what I thought was kind of funny. I'm not sure if you caught this, but. So during the hardest shot, Ovechkin was in it, and he broke a stick.
Yeah.
He didn't have any sticks.
And then the radar didn't pick up one of his shots.
Yeah.
Too. Who's running the show there?
And it was weird because during the intermission, and they talked about it on CBC, so we're totally going off here, but they talked about it on CBC that the players were in there getting all this stuff signed. Like, not the normal stuff you get from it, but like, and I saw Ovechkin walking around with a stick. I thought, that's cool. And then when he broke his stick, I thought, I wonder if he has any more sticks. And he's like, I don't have more sticks. But he used Letang.
Yeah.
So it's like,
exactly.
Oh. Like, I don't know, that kind of stuff, that gets me
off. Yeah, that's kind of cool.
Gets me off.
Not good for the stick manufacturer.
No, not really.
At that point, when everyone's watching that one moment, not like a game when you break a stick and everyone's like, oh. Yeah. Anywho.
I'm not sure where I am in my spiel. We're going to open packs.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, I have this is our 1997 Upper Deck Collector's Choice with Patty Roy. I think these are chippies, which is exciting.
I got the 03-04 Victory, Upper Deck Victory hobby cards with Danny Heatley.
We're going to have a shot?
We're going to have a shot.
All right, sweet. I'll wait for you to get ready. While he's getting ready, I posted this on Facebook, and I'm just still kind of over the moon about it, but...
the
I'm not even on meds. Anyways, my grandma sent me an email, and it was a video clip from the commercial that they're using for the Heritage Classic, which
is
coming
so
up.
That is so cool.
And it just all the email was is the subject line is like Scott's Pond after many days of filming, and then there's a link to this commercial. I'm like, what are you guys talking about? So whatever. Sure enough, he was in a coffee shop that he lives up north, like Muskoka area. And whatever, got to talking to these guys from the NHL. They're looking for a pond. He said, oh, come by my place. They liked his place. Cleaned it all up. Were there for like a week.
That's
doing
awesome.
Like all their stills and stuff. And then I guess there was like 20 guys up there skating around. So I think there might be maybe more commercials coming. Fed them breakfast, watched a football game with them all.
That's awesome. It's like, awesome.
And he has no idea if they're NHLers. So I'm excited to see the rest of the commercials and see if it's anything or if it's just legs and stuff.
But, yeah, exactly.
But he's not into hockey. My uncle doesn't watch it. So he said, I only know like first names. But I don't know. It was awesome. So there you go. So let's cheers.
Where does he live?
I don't know. Like, I want to say Baysville area, but I'm probably not.
Yeah, that's wrong. That's up
there. But up there.
Lake Bays.
Cool. Cheers, guys.
Cheers. Alrighty. Got some. Oh, that's a lip burner.
Fresh bottle. Oh, yeah. Now, you go first, then you can get one more.
All right. Well, I got your boy first.
That's not my boy.
Whatever. I got Mike Komisarek here with the Montreal Canadien. This is his rookie card.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh,
well, that's
crap.
One season, 21 games played. That's kind of fitting, because I was going to say... he's healthy now, and he's played most of the games this year. I will
yes,
give him that.
Yes.
He played like half of them last year.
Yeah.
Yeah, and signed the big contract with the Leafs.
That big free agent signing, here he
comes.
Yeah,
a little more than maybe he was worth. I like him in his interviews. I think he sounds like an all right dude.
Yeah.
But it's and he is a hard hitter, probably tough to play against, but it's I think it's a health thing for me. Then again, it's a... defensive core on that team.
The big joke is that he was the you look at him now and he was voted in when he was in Montreal as an all-star when they did everybody, like when they voted everybody in a couple years ago in Montreal. So that's a big joke. But I don't know, Komisarek, I wasn't a big fan when he came over. He had that, I think it was his first game he got in a fight with a guy, or second game he got a fight with a guy, took him down, stood up and then picked the guy back up and kept punching him. I was impressed with that. But now, yeah, he's not the best at all. And he apparently punched a chick in the nightclub in L.A. or whatever.
Oh, really?
I think that was him, right?
Nice.
Yeah. You hear that?
No, that's awesome.
TMZ was all over.
Yeah, I love that kind of stuff. And we like to talk about that stuff. It's not real nice to the player, but hey, it's what we do.
Apparently, it's getting shot down a little bit more now, so whatever.
That it didn't happen?
Yeah. Apparently... I'm almost positive with him. It's gonna, I'm like an idiot. It wasn't.
That did happen.
But it was a post on Puck Daddy talking about it, and that apparently he picked this chick up over his head. The chick was like, "Put me down."
Oh, it was a joke. Like,
yeah, like, oh.
She didn't like her.
Put me down. And she punched him, and he punched her back.
Wow,
that's the story. And then Wyshynski had an amazing quote, something like, well, you know, when you pick up a girl and pretend she's a Stanley Cup without asking her, what do you expect?
That's awesome. I didn't know anything about that. That's wicked. I'm going to be looking that up.
Yeah, I got a couple good cards here to get going. I got all Dominic Hasek. That's my first card, which is nice. The Dominator.
Dominator, yeah.
Didn't have the best time in Ottawa, and then kind of fucked Cujo a little bit there in Detroit.
He did.
Wasn't a big fan. Like, I wasn't a huge
same
fan
here,
of him.
Though, but...
Maybe because he was good. So like, you know how you hate guys sometimes.
Yeah, like everyone hates Crosby.
Yeah,
everyone hated
shit.
Wayne. And yeah.
I didn't like his floppiness. Like,
yeah,
Tim Thomas
yeah.
seems a bit more controlled. But Hasek's like fucking all over.
Yeah,
the place.
And that's probably an accurate assessment. Thomas is a little floppy. But yeah, a little more control. I don't know. As a former goaltender, yeah, I hated his style. Ugh.
Yeah.
But effective. And when you're winning Hart trophies,
yeah.
and Vezina after Vezina.
And I was actually just looking this up.
He's an idiot, though. Like, I've heard he's a real dick.
Didn't he hide, like, the karate chop a guy and rollerblade hop
yeah.
in the neck or something?
He's sorely.
It's all these domestics coming up. And I was just looking this up because I'm pretty horny on Tim Thomas this year. And
I noticed that. The way he plays.
I love him.
Yeah. Did you like how he's mic'd up there in the third period?
Oh,
that's
great. Distracting the whole time. The last NHL goaler to win the Vezina with the goals against under two was Hasek.
Oh, that's right, because they're talking about it, right?
And Tim Thomas is right near him. He's
yeah.
like 186 or something.
And he's got the highest save percentage since they started
yeah.
recording it.
Can
he keep that up?
50 or something.
Yeah.
That's
945, yeah, 950. Yeah, it isn't.
Sick. Yep, Donner, whatever, good.
Cool, okay, well, I'm about the same level of play as Dominic Hasek. I have, I can't even say that with a straight face, Matty Stajan.
Hey, Ragin.
Also his rookie card. Wow, these two rookie cards for... Leafs and former Leafs are worth $0.25 put together.
Yeah.
Now, in saying that, I like Matt Stajan. He's a former Belleville Bull, so I like to get those plugs in. Had a good junior career with Belleville, played for the World Juniors. Had a good start to his career with the Leafs. I think he scored in his first game. Had a couple of decent seasons, not crazy. And of course, the big trade, which just happened a couple of days ago.
Yeah.
A year ago. And he's doing nothing now. Calgary's terrible.
But he got that goal against Toronto when he came
back. Yeah, I was there. So that was one of his two or three this year. Yeah, he's struggling over there, and they thought he was going to be the center for Iginla. And of course, Iginla hasn't had a good center since Conroy.
No, that could be over.
Yeah, that's a shame. But yeah, Matty Stajan.
I got a guy. I got Wayne Gretzky. We don't get a whole.
I got a guy.
We don't get a lot of just straight up Wayne Gretzky cards. But that's just straight up Wayne Gretzky. These are 97, so not quite retirement year. But fucking Gretzky, that's good shit. Just turned 50.
Another thing that was all over the place.
I was amazed how. That was everywhere.
Yeah, I was very happy with how people were promoting it. There was always a few jackasses, though, that, like we said about people that hate greatness, that always come out of the woodwork. I even put it on my Facebook status. Happy birthday. Please refrain from any Mario, Bobby Orr, Gordie Howe references today. And speaking of All-Star games, and goes kind of hand-in-hand with what I was saying before or weeks ago, that I don't really like it now. Lately on the NHL Network, during the break, they've been playing past All-Star games.
Ooh.
So the other night I watched the 1980, which was Gordy's last and his first. And then they played the 83 one where he scored four in the third. And the game, even though the level of hockey was different, because now everyone's bigger and stronger and faster, it was more, it's just, you could tell it was just more competitive. There was penalties, there was hitting. Not like smoking, but there was,
a little bit of...
Yeah, some bumping and grinding in the corners. This guy's digging for fun. Bumping and grinding, if you will.
Song?
Anyway, we're on topic. But Wayne, yeah, I love him. You love him. And you love him.
Yeah, 100%.
Oh, yeah, me.
We love Wayne. Everyone loves Wayne.
Well, your next card's rocking the cash box.
Oh, yeah, I'm dominating.
My next card sucks because I don't even know this guy. Jim Fahey or Fahey. His rookie card. Wow, I'm loaded with rookie cards. Jim Fahey, help us out. San Jose Sharks, I don't have a clue.
No.
Never heard of him. Sorry.
I know this guy, and actually a little bit of a crush, maybe. Brendan Shanahan.
I have a crush.
Here hugging...
that's... Jeff Sanderson.
I was going to say Samuelson. I had it wrong. Yeah.
Jeff Sanderson, yeah.
Who,
that's
weird. I think it's weird. We're kind of talking...
Well, he's a former Whaler, right? So
yes.
Maybe there's a...
Well, that's why... it's kind of weird that they're all hugging and helmets off and stuff. Like, maybe this is a...
Is it an All-Star game?
That's what I'm thinking. But it's weird. They got lots of All-Star game stuff here. Because he's the guy that's... I guess he's put his hat on this a little bit.
Yeah, I was going to say, we can talk about his career, but we can might better talk about what
he's
doing.
I like it.
Doing
whatever.
Now.
What he's doing, it's fine. Fine and dandy.
Yeah,
I like it.
Yeah, it's a good first effort, and they should just go with it and see if they can expand. I know there's been lots of talk online about people wanting to see sticks thrown.
What the heck? Oh, God.
If you're going to go old school or... playground style throw sticks.
Yeah, like
but yeah, I don't know. The draft was neat.
That's fun.
Really neat to see Phil Kessel go with. Anyway, Shanny.
I knew it was going
to
happen. So.
Yeah, it was almost predictable. Like, Shanny, you got to love him. One of my favorite players of all time.
He's a. Second episode we had I had a Shanahan card. That's a long time. That's a long span.
Yeah. And we're approaching 100. Okay, speaking of $100 billion,
we
have Eddie B. Ed Belfour here with the Leafs, that's kind of cool. I'll give you $1 billion to not talk about Ed Belfour.
You got a lot of former Leafs and Leafs.
Yeah, no doubt. Eddie B., of course, we mentioned it earlier in the year that Craig, our contest winner, got to meet him.
Yep.
That's cool. Of course, he had a pretty storied career, and he's up for the Hall next year, I believe.
Really?
And is Shanny up for the Hall next year? Or is he up for the Hall this year, and Shanny's up next year? I don't know. It's hard to keep track when all these guys packed it in.
Is he hanging up in Jersey, yeah? Like 2 years ago?
Yeah.
How long did he have to wait? 4 or 5?
3.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah, and he hung it up in 08, Florida, or I don't know. Mm. Like I said, it's hard to keep track now. And then you got guys like Forsberger to come back and let it linger.
Oh.
But yeah, Eddie B, the sweet man.
I have Byron Defoe here with L.A., Lord Byron.
Lord Byron, nice.
From Sussex, England.
It's English?
Apparently.
I know that.
That was a weird
Did he play for Team England? Because, you know, they have a team.
No, but Chippy says, we haven't heard from Chippy yet, the first player in Kings history to have his number retired was Rogge Vachon, who played for LA from 71-72 to 77-78. Yeah. So they don't even have anything to talk about Byron Defoe.
Nice.
So they're going to say, hey, well, Rogge Vachon.
What year are these? Because Byron Defoe after this, what, Boston in the picture? And who's that? I don't know.
Boston.
But went on and had pretty good years in Boston.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. Whatever.
I like Lord Byron. He was okay. He kind of just fizzled out and you didn't hear from him.
No, not
at all.
Weird
when you, and he was a number one goalie. He's number one guys. And then
he played for Atlanta as well.
Yeah, I think maybe near the end or. He played for, you know, it doesn't say. Did he play for Washington before LA? I can't remember.
It only says 1 year here.
Yeah.
Huh.
Anywho. What the?
Yeah, split
tiny
goaltending duties with Stefan '96-'97.
Feces. Okay, I have Ladislav Nagy here with the Phoenix Coyote. Highly touted Nagy started with St. Louis. This is not his rookie card, obviously, because he started with St. Louis. Went to Phoenix in the Keith Kachuk, or AKA Fathead, trade. And then Nagy had a couple good years with Phoenix, is what I remember. Because I know he was like a middle to late round pool pick.
Mm-hmm.
Guys picking him up. And then kind of disappeared. He went somewhere after Phoenix.
Wow.
I want to say LA as well, but I can't remember.
I was going to say San Jose, but
I was thinking Dallas or LA. I don't know.
Or it could be Carolina.
I think
or Florida.
He's got to still be playing. I think he's
maybe
playing in
Tampa.
Europe. Hey, let's just throw teams out.
My mom's calling. Should I answer?
Yeah, well, maybe it's about your uncle's pond.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, shit. Yeah, I don't know where he is now. He's Slovakian. I think he's playing in Europe somewhere. Let's go with the Swiss League, the Swedish League, the Russian
League. Yeah,
that's good. Somewhere over there.
Okay, my last card is a name. It sounds familiar. I think maybe from World Junior stuff, but I don't. Did he ever play? I have Cameron Mann.
Cameron Mann, former Peterborough Pete.
Oh, really?
Played for the Petes when I was in college there. I think he did play for the World Juniors.
Yeah, 97 World Juniors on the back.
Yeah,
Johnston.
97 is a winner. 97 was a gold medal team.
Is that Big Joe?
That is Big Joe.
Who's that?
Oh, that looks very familiar. Not Tucker, is it? I don't know. It's weird.
I don't know. Big Joe on the back.
Big
though,
Joe. Man. Yeah. Anyway, cameraman, I don't think he had very much NHL experience, if any. But he was, again, highly touted. Had some pretty good years for Peterborough when I was there. And obviously was good enough to make the World Juniors. He's from up north, too. Like, somewhere up north. When I say that, I mean in Canada. Not, like, Moosonee, Jonathan Chichu up north, but he's somewhere up there. Like, maybe the Sioux or something.
Like Thompson, Manitoba?
Yeah. Is that where he's from?
Yeah.
Is he from Manitoba? All right, then not even in Ontario.
I was supposed to see how many games he played. I wasn't trying to cheat.
No, that's fine. Sometimes we need help. He did play for the Beats.
Jack 99th overall, Boston. He currently plays for the Nottingham Panthers.
He's still playing.
Signing in July 09. He formerly played for some other team.
Yeah.
And then
how many games in the NHL?
Ooh.
Any?
Shit, doesn't even say.
I don't think he made it.
Hold on. Oh, here we go. Internet Hockey Database.
I don't think he did.
Drum roll.
There goes my red lips.
Boston Bruins. He had 9 games in 97-98.
Wow.
1 point.
Corrected.
And then 98-99, he had 33.
Wow.
The next year, he had 32.
Wow. Okay. So he's got...
Then 15. Then he went to Nashville for 4 games.
He's pushing 100.
And then he left.
How many is that career?
93 career games.
93.
24 points.
Yeah, that's too bad.
One playoff game.
Junior career. Anyway,
there you be.
There you be. Yeah, I remember these hero, national heroes.
Yeah, he looks jacked. What's he
gonna bite on his blade there?
I ate my hockey stick.
All right, we're rambling. And it's early, and we plan on filming another. Okay, my last card is a game breaker here for Jocelyn Thibault with the Blackhawks. Jocelyn Thibault, we all know, started with Quebec, went to Colorado with the team.
With the team.
I say that every time now. Went over to Montreal in the Waugh trade. A couple okay years in Montreal. Went over to Chicago in the Hackett trade with a bunch of other doodlies. Eric Weinrich, maybe, some other guys. Manson. And then had his best years in Chicago, so that's good. He's a game breaker. Then he ended up in Pittsburgh?
Pittsburgh, yeah, he did. It was right around the time of everyone started to, they were kind of like a turnaround.
Like when Mario came back and Sid came
back. Yeah, kind of thing.
Was it before, he was there before Sid?
I think before Sid, maybe like right around Sid, but then Fleury also with Sid. So, but
and then what happened to him?
I think so.
Yeah, that's too bad. Because he's not that old, is he?
The funny thing with him is that, you know, we're Canadian, eh? So we can see Thibault and know that it's Thibault. But maybe some of the guys down in Pittsburgh couldn't. And I remember in their paper, like on their blogs and shit, some of them had them like phonetically spelt, as you like to say. And it's T-Bow, so they're helping
really
him out.
Helping
like, this is your new goalie. This is his name.
Well, that's true. Because there used to be, I don't know if it was Stump the Schwab or one of those U.S. trivia shows, and a guy got Rick Tocchet and said, Rick Tosche.
Nice.
And me and a couple of buddies were watching and still laughing.
Ooh,
he's still laughing, but, oh, Tosche! He said, no, we say it every time when we talk about Rick Tosche. Usually when we're playing poker or gambling.
Uh-oh.
Yikes. Anywho.
Sweet. All right. Three-star selection.
Fast.
Yeah, it was, eh?
I think.
You know what? It was probably 10 minutes before we even got into one. 3-star selection, that's brought to you by Ice Hot Hockey. They are 100% hockey cards for the hardcore NHL fan. You can check out all their auctions over on their eBay homepage. Just gotta search for them by using Ice Hot Hockey, all one word, and you'll see all the good, good, good stuff they have to offer. Okay. Actually, before we get into that, Ice Hot Hockey hooked us up with a prize last month for our hockey pool, and actually, Kate Breton Superstars won again.
Again.
So 2 months in a row, I'm not sure if this is going to be just, he's going to sweep it through.
Yeah,
he's
what's
got
going
like
on?
A 15-point lead right now. I don't know. But
good
this this month, our buddy over on Grinder Threads is going to hook up the February winner with T, so.
Good job,
big
yeah.
ups and thanks.
Grinder Threads. Check them out.
Okay, not you. Well, this is fucking easy.
Well, I'm ready. Yeah, I'm ready. Yours are stellar.
Stanley
yours
Cups
are Hall of Famers.
Like trophies.
So let me
shit.
Go with my questionable because I have maybe one Hall of Famer. Or actually one Hall of Famer. All right, I'm going to give third star because I'm a homer and I'm a Belleville boy. Matty Stajan. Sorry about the crappy year you're having, Matt. Game Breakers card, Jocelyn Thibault for second star and first star to the Billion Dollar Man at Belfort.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Yeah, I got a beautiful lineup
a
here.
A bit.
And actually, this is kind of interesting, right? The Olympics?
Yeah.
Okay, so I got Dominic Hasek because he's going to be my number 3-star, only because he sounds like he has marbles in his mouth when he talks.
Dominator.
Number 2, I'm going with Brendan Shanahan because I have a small crush on him, and we got to see him and do a little interview action and shit like that.
Yes,
so, hey, what up? What up?
Yes, we
And
do.
Number 1, I think I'd probably get punched in the nuts if I didn't give Wayne Gretzky the number 1 star. Happy birthday, Wayne. And
that's hilarious that you said the Olympics, because here we have 1998 in the semis, Dominic Hasek stopping Brendan Shanahan as one of the 5 shooters, and Wayne on the bench. Way to go, Mark Crawford, another Belleville boy. Good choice. Ray Bork should be shooting, because he's good at targets. Not so many breakaways in his career.
All right, guys, thanks for watching this episode number 94. We are closing on 100. Still
yes,
trying
we
to
are.
Figure out something amazing to do. We'll probably end up just sitting on the couch.
Yeah, maybe we'll put on a suit.
Yeah. Well, like a Dumb and Dumber, like a blue and an orange.
Yeah.
Or a birthday.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Anywho, cheers.
Cheers, guys.
Go Leafs, go.
Cheers. Hey, I'm going in a few weeks.
Yeah?
Yep. Oh, back-to-back weeks. February 26th, I'm taking my son. That was the secret that I didn't want to say.
Oh, yeah.
About Crosby, when you were talking about Crosby before Christmas. Mm-hmm. I'm taking my son February 26th to see Pittsburgh and the Leafs. Hopefully Crosby plays, because that's his. He loves the Leafs, but Crosby's his favorite player. So get healthy, Sid. And then the next week, I'm going with a couple of buddies to see the Blackhawks.
That'd be fun. You can borrow my jersey if you want.
Yeah? I'll probably fit into that. Back-to-back weeks at the That's ACC. Nice. What is going on?
You're
going to
be pop.
Yeah. My Red Wing buddies are going to probably be angry.
Go to Leaf games, man.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.